As tensions are ratcheting up between Russia and Ukraine, one Democratic congressman says his office is getting phone calls, repeatedly getting these phone calls, and they're from fans of Fox's chief propagandist, Tucker Carlson, saying that the U.S. should be siding with Russia over Ukraine. What, you may say? Well, you wouldn't be surprised if you watched his pro-Russia stance every night.
All of them are promoting war against Russia on behalf of our new and deeply beloved ally, the government of Ukraine. Vladimir Putin is our most dangerous enemy, they scream. We can't let him hurt Ukraine. So it turns out Russiagate was actually more effective even than we'd realized. The Steele dossier has been debunked, but in Washington, the theme remains in force. Russia, 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 Russia is bad. Apparently, Ukraine's eastern border with Russia, unlike, say, our southern border with Mexico, is a sacred boundary created by God that must be protected at all costs, up to and including American lives. Why is it disloyal to side with Russia, but loyal to side with Ukraine? They're both foreign countries that don't care anything about the United States. Kind of strange.
Easy answer there. One's a democracy, the other's a brutal autocracy. The real question here may be, why is Rupert Murdoch allowing this anti-democratic BS on the air there? Let's talk about all of this now with Democratic Congressman Tom Malinowski of New Jersey. He is on the House Foreign Affairs and Homeland Security Committees, among others. First, sir, and thank you for being with us this morning. Can you just tell us about these phone calls that your office is getting?
Sure. It really started yesterday. I was in my district office in New Jersey, and phones were ringing, and my district director came to me and said, I just spent an hour on the phone with like four people telling me that they'd watched Tucker Carlson last night, and why are we going to be going to war for Ukraine? Russia's making reasonable proposals for peace, and we should just do what Russia wants. And you know, I knew this was happening. I've actually had many conversations with Republican colleagues in the House of Representatives about what's happening on Fox with respect to Russia. But this was the first time I started feeling it from my own constituents who were watching this garbage.
And so, I mean, the line is direct here. Tucker Carlson says something and they parrot it, right?
Yes, and I mean that's not surprising, right? People watch TV and they pick up stuff. And in this case, you know, we have such a partisan media environment where there are some people who only watch people like Tucker Carlson, and that's all they get night after night after night. And he's whipped them up into believing we're going to war, which is, as you just reported, not the case. We're not. President Biden is not promising to fight for Ukraine. We're just taking the side of a democracy that is being threatened with invasion by a dictatorship. Because ever since World War II, it's been America's policy in the world that dictators shouldn't get to change borders with tanks. That's how World War II started. It's important to us not to let that happen. I mean, and, you know, so this is, it's really, really disturbing. And I think the main point here is we have to be united about this. And in Congress, Republicans and Democrats, so far, this is the good news, we're pretty united in standing by Ukraine, recognizing Putin as our adversary. But I think some of my Republican colleagues have got to come face to face with the fact that one of their chief propagandists, who's putting out this stuff to millions of their supporters every night, is effectively taking Russia's side.
So then let's talk about what you think Republicans should do, because, you know, a federal judge said in a somewhat recent case that was, you know, Fox and Tucker Carlson, Fox's lawyers defended Carlson effectively. They said basically people don't believe him. They know that it's not real. Clearly, people do believe him. They're calling up your office and just repeating what he says. What do Republicans need to do?
They've got to call this out, and some of them have. You know, there was a Republican congressman who went on Carlson's show a couple of months ago and debated him on Ukraine. It was very good, but it didn't stop Fox News from putting this out to people every night. And, you know, I got to say, I've raised this with some of my Republican colleagues in the last few days, and they say, what? I didn't know that. They pretend it's not happening, because it's an uncomfortable subject. Of course, it's not just Tucker Carlson. it goes back to the Trump administration and the former president, and it's just hard for them to acknowledge there's a segment of their party that is siding with Russia. And I think they've got to acknowledge it and confront it, as uncomfortable as it is, because most of them actually, you know, I mean, we agree on the policy. We agree the United States has got to defend democracies when dictators like Putin try to seize their territory by force. And if we're going to sustain that policy, we've got to communicate why that's important to the American people, to every side of the political spectrum.
So Tucker Carlson, obviously, I mean, he enjoys freedom of speech. This is America. He can say whatever the heck he wants. But in Russia, critics are poisoned. They're killed. His opinions are anti-democratic. I try to think about what would happen if the shoe were on the other foot here. What conservatives might say if, you know, Barack Obama was saying something like this and media was supporting what he said.
Imagine if Democrats or liberals after 9/11 were going on TV and saying, well, you know, that was bad, but, you know, the terrorists have legitimate grievances and we should, you know, we should negotiate with them and give them what they want. Yeah, free speech, but I think that the American people would have no tolerance for that sort of thing. And I think, you know, we've got to apply a similar standard here. Of course he has a right to his opinions. Everybody has a right to their opinions, but none of us have a right to have a primetime show on Fox News or CNN or any other network to be able to say this kind of nonsense to millions of people every night.
Well, I will say, here we are talking about him, which I think is exactly what he wants, and maybe that's why he says some of this craziness. Congressman...
Well, let's use it as an opportunity to talk about why it's important to stand by Ukraine here and why what Putin is doing is a threat to America's national security. Let's turn it around.
Yeah, and thank you so much for being here to do that. Congressman Tom Malinowski, we appreciate you.